drove all of you before you came here. And it is what will drive all of us apart. It is why we must be stingy. Stingy with our trust. Stingy to those who we speak of and to. Trust is far too precious. It is essential to our survival. We must be stingy with it. And we must be stingy with those who we give it to, and to only those who we trust. But who do we trust? I want all of you to look around this room. The amount of trust you hand out should always equal the amount of people in this room. And it should only be given to those in this room. We are stingy because we have no allowance. You see, the price of mistrust will bankrupt you. It will bankrupt your mind, your soul, and your person. And it will destroy this family. Now, who do we trust?
Us!
Almost didn't recognize you since you up and disappeared.
Well, hello. Here I am. Nice to see you too. Happy now?
You have no idea what the hell I've been through to find you.
Well, sorry to tell you, but you wasted your time.
So that's it, huh?
What?
It's been what? A year now? No calls, no happy birthdays. Not even a sign that you're even alive. I finally find you and all I get from you is a immediate goodbye. But hey, it's more than what I got last time.
Well, what do you expect? A banner? Oh, cake! Or an appreciation trophy. I'm better off gone. And quite frankly, I'm surprised you bothered.
You know that's not true.
It's not?
Marilyn, I miss you.
You know, I never had a family.
You had me. Where mom took you when you were family.
I had a hard time believing that.
No, I did too sometimes. I remember I used to try to sign off as your mother in school.
Guess what? Wait to grow up and leave. Look, I really am happy to see you. It's just, I can't leave.
What do you mean you can't leave?
Well, this is the only place I know. This is the only family I got.
What does that make me then?
You will always be my sister. It's just, I can't go back.
Well, I'm staying here until you decide you can.
Well, I think you're gonna stay longer than you thought. Anyways.
Okay, what are you talking about?
I don't know if you have noticed, but this isn't kind of place that people wander in and out of, usually.
That's why we haven't heard from you?
No. It's people here get a little paranoid and try to at least blend in a bit.
What was that?
Oh, dinner. Go first. Oh, wait a minute. And don't forget, blend in.
And who is that?
The new girl.
I know that. Who is she?
Her name is Alyssa.
And?
And she seems determined.
Is that all you know?
I'm not sure. What do you mean?
Well, you were in there for quite some time, and that seemed a bit more than quick chit-chat. I guess you have a way with people. And I know you would never keep anything from us.
Of course not. And I know you wouldn't question me.
Of course not. Now let's eat. My apologies, Alyssa. I feel like we haven't been properly introduced. You see, here, we're a place for people to go further in their life. Kale, why don't you explain to Alyssa just who you were?
Before Duke took me in, I was just nobody less than nobody. I was just a junkie out on the streets. All I knew was drugs. I bought drugs, I used drugs. Sold drugs. And one day I sold a dog to a friend of mine and he ended up ODing on it. So after that, I tried quitting. I tried just giving it up on my own. I tried going to rehab. I tried going to meetings, but none of it worked. That was when Duke took me in.
And Dana, how about you?
I came from a very abusive household. My mother hated being sober and she hated me even more. And I was really broken and angry. I would take that anger out on everyone that I could. And I held on to it for a really long time. I didn't think that anyone would ever love me. But the Duke did. He loves all of us. I'm no longer mad because of him.
And I believe you've already met Marilyn.
We talked earlier. She's a very lovely woman.
She absolutely is. But I don't think any of us have heard your story.
Me? Oh, guess I've just always been a wanderer.
Oh, like traveling.
Yeah, you know, just traveling with no destination.
And you just happen to travel here.
I mean, I can't say this by accident. I mean, I heard about this place.
From whom?
You know, just around town.
Kale, how many people have you seen just wander in here?
None that I can think of.
And Dana, how about you?
Well, I'm very stingy with my money. I would not waste my allowance on her.
And Marilyn, what do you think?
Personally, I think she's a nice woman. Probably too nice. I don't think she's a good fit for us.
You know what? I don't think so either, so if you don't mind, I'm gonna see myself out.
You understand that's not possible.
Duke, I don't think this is necessary.
I've told you, there would be someone that would come and invade our home and try and break apart our family. And for you to defend someone like that sounds like you're betraying our family. And I know you, and I know you'd never. So please, prove to me that I am not wrong about you. It is why we must be stingy. Stingy with our trust. Trust is far too precious. We are stingy because we have no allowance. You see, the price of mistrust will bankrupt you. Now who do we trust?